Well, here's my $3.99 bargain I got off of eBay. And at first glance, it doesn't look like much, but let's take a closer look and see why I think it's such a bargain. This screwdriver's got a nice handle on it, nice design to it. Can't make out a name on it, but this shank was either made, or this tip, or was made or modified to a sort of rectangular instead of a square drive. To suppose you to fit an application, but I think a user modified this, which leads me to the junk pit for this one. This seems to be a Stanley item. It looks the Stanley design on it. I can't make out a name on it. Maybe once it's cleaned, I can find out exactly what it is. It's a nice screwdriver. It'll be a nice user screwdriver, even if it is not a name brand. Here's one that's definitely a Stanley. Stanley number 2731. Phillips. Looks like a Phillips number 1 point. Missing the ferrule, but I think this could be painted up and fixed up to where that ferrule looks really nice on there. It's a nice screwdriver. Here's another Stanley number 2742. That great Stanley color they put on your screwdrivers. 3 inch long, number 2. Phillips point. That'll clean up nice. And what really led me to it was spying this perfect handle screwdriver. And now that I have it in hand, you can see it says Irwin, US of A. Now that's the trademark they use. So this is a perfect handle screwdriver. Tip is in good shape. The shank is straight. A lot of patina on the metal. Not a lot of dents on the back end. The handle in good shape. Not chipped or cracked or pulled away from the metal. So this is gonna shine up nicely and be a beautiful addition to my screwdriver collection. So there's my $3.99 bundle. We'll see what we can do with it. And here are the results of the $3.99 batch of screwdrivers I bought. You can give some old life to these old tools and make them useful and look a lot nicer too. Of course, the first one with the weird tip, there's just not much use for that. Wasn't much I could do with it. Just put it over in the later pile to see if maybe I want to do something with it later, but really not a lot of use for it. The second item was this nice Phillips, number 2 Phillips screwdriver, and the ferrule was missing, and of course it was just a little old and used, so we put a nice look to it, painted the handle up, actually painted the ferrule. I hope I'm going to look for a ferrule to put on here. But didn't really have anything. But really turned out nice. It'll be look a lot better in my toolbox. It's a user tool. Next was this Stanley screwdriver. Cleaned it up. Painted the ferrule portion. Again, this one didn't have a ferrule on it, so I gave it a little color to make it look a little better. And that'll also be a nice tool for my toolbox. Next was this little stubby screwdriver. And actually was a nice screwdriver, and I needed one this size. So cleaned it up and put some nice paint on it. Actually, I've got a new red paint. Never have enough. This is called Toolbox Red. It was a Rust-Oleum paint, and actually I like it. Gives it a nice finish and really gave some nice life to this old screwdriver. This Stanley, nice item, classic screwdriver with the classic Stanley color. I didn't sand it or do any refinishing or repainting on it because I wanted to keep the Stanley name and part number, Stanley 2742. So basically just did a cleanup, gave it a coat of wax, Again, nice little number two stubby. And have that one available for my toolbox too. And lastly, which is the main reason why I bought this lot of them, was this perfect handle screwdriver. It was in very sad shape. But we all love restoring these, and they restore nicely, and this one just came out beautiful. You can see the difference there. The handle took a lot of scraping and sanding, but was able to get it restored nicely. It had a little gouge on the backside, which I couldn't take out with sanding. I sanded as much as I could. But this will be the show side. I'm going to put this on my display board with my other perfect tools because it is an Irwin U.S. of A. name imprinted right in the shank of it. And, of course, the tip was bad. All the metal was shattered pretty bad. The end had been hammered on a lot, so we smoothed it out and put it together. So that shows you can give some for $3.99. Got a nice few screwdrivers from a toolbox and made them look a little nicer because I don't like these sad-looking tools. Since I've been working on them, I got to clean them up. And gave them a nice look, and I've got a nice showpiece for my display board. I recently showed you some items I restored for my son. I saved a picture of them. Didn't have any before on it. It was done some time ago before I started taking a lot of photography, but I did snap a picture of it after I completed them, and they turned out nice. And so he rewarded me today with some additional items. Rewarded means he brought some tools for me to restore. He said, I can't have these ugly tools in my toolbox. So that means I got a little project ahead of me. But hey, he's my son. He's family. He gets it free. First, this nice wrench. It's a little rough working. It's a pretty sad shape. We'll get it together for him. Nice crescent type wrench. Fulton brand. It says Fulton on both sides. 8 for 8 inch tools, drop forged and tool steel. Pretty banged up and beat up. I'll get some love on that one. Next is a little pair of needle nose pliers. These come in handy as long as they work well. And 2 files with a wood handle. Once the files cleaned up, renewed, and of course he wants a nice finish put on the handles. So work cut out for me. I'll be taking care of that along with my other projects. And just as a little other note, seem like every time my son straightens out his toolbox, he finds something that he's not happy with in his wrenches, so he brings them over to me to freshen them up for him. Not necessarily looking for beauty or wall hangers. He just likes to have his tools looking nice. So glad to oblige him. First was this nice auto wrench. And I decided to do a little red, of course. Cleaned it up, put some red on it. It'll look nice in the toolbox. Nice little crescent style wrench. See, can't remember. It's called Fulton brand. And of course it has a lot of pitting and so forth on it, but it was pretty crummy, so we cleaned it up and gave it an original look, which is the black. Nice little set of pliers. Those cleaned up nicely, nothing special on the handle or anything, so we just put the cleanup on them and made them presentable. And then a couple of files. He seems to keep coming up with these, so I decided to give him a little cleanup to the file and then a little color to the handle. just to dress them up. Now, there was my family project for the week. We have them come up every so often. Glad to do it for family.